God, what is that smell? This Maya god is very dark brown, almost black, with black-rimmed eyes and facial features that seem to be melting at their extremities. This can only be Exua. He's the patron god of the cacao bean, which accounts for his coloring. Also, because ancient Mesoamericans used those beans as currency, Exua became by extension a god of merchants and of trade. Interestingly, when he first appeared in the lore, he was a god of conflict. Feeding on the corpses. Have to find a way up. Anchuelo Serrano, and these are likely the last words I write. Andreas Lopez, or Angel de la Cruz, as he has called himself these last years, has finally and fully gone insane. His demands have grown, becoming more grueling and grotesque as we labor to build his crypt. The construction is almost complete. I know I will die when it is done, Lopez, in a brief moment of clarity, told me himself. Damn that box. Damn what it has done to the man I once, and sadly still, admire. Storms crash and rivers swell. Direct the waters to quench the thirst of the gods who toil above and below.
Thank you.
This pendant is decorated in the Incan tradition, but the effigy clearly appears to be an Aztec warrior. That shouldn't be possible. Several hundreds have renounced their pagan beliefs and turned to the teaching of Catholicism. Our work here is different. The heathens must learn the language and then the teachings. Most are not receptive, but only come looking for conversion to the true Lord from fear of what might happen to them if they do not. No matter, all paths lead to God's light. In the evenings, I rest easily, comforted by the conviction we will save these poor, lost souls. Excerpt from the Journal of Beltran, Ordinius Predicatorum. All full up. Can't carry any more. This leather-bound volume of prayers seems to be from the late 16th century. It's in remarkable condition.
She must be close.
She?
The Empress Jaguar. As soon as she shows up, every other animal shuts up. No need to attract her attention, right?
Right. Shouldn't we be quiet too then? 18th of December, 1604. I've neglected this journal for far too long. We've worked hard to build the mission. Every day more people arrive. Native villagers seeking conversion. Soldiers tired of war. Others whose faith has been tested by the long, dangerous journey through the jungle. All lured by Lopez's gospel of purity through labor. We work from sunrise to sunset, and then Lopez, or Angel de la Cruz as he now calls himself, spends his evening preaching the mission's purpose, to test the Chosen One. He's calmed considerably, and if he believes something pursues him still, he keeps it to himself. Tomorrow we begin to build a library, where the box will safely rest until it is ready to be found by the Chosen One.